Sunday So What. Yesterday was a big day, y'all. It was Easter, and I don't know about y'all, but it came really, really fast, honestly. And you know, it wasn't a typical Easter. It wasn't a normal Easter, I guess you could say, because we weren't able to meet on campus, but hey, it was still Easter, right? And it was so cool to still be able to meet online and to worship and celebrate Jesus conquering death and rising from the grave. I'm getting to talk more about that unshakable and that secured hope that we can have in Jesus. And so if you didn't have a chance to go watch Drew's sermon, make sure you go do that. It was super, super good. It should be on our church website because it's recorded, so you should be able to still watch that. But I know it was a good reminder for me personally, and honestly a good reminder any day of the year, even if it's not Easter. So if you have time, go check that out. But yeah, that's kind of my plug for that. But I'm just gonna jump straight into what Drew talked about. So he started out by explaining that a lot of times in life things happen that aren't expected, and things happen that are sudden, right? And that a lot of times when this happens, we get thrown off guard. And one example of that can be COVID-19, right? I know I wasn't expecting that. That definitely was not on my calendar. But it's in times like these that we're able to recognize that we really do need this unshakable and secured hope in our lives, and that we can't get that through anything else in life, because life is changing and it's not secure. And so Drew goes more into detail about how we can get this hope and what that looks like. And so he is going to be in, he goes into Mark 8, 31 through 38 this week. So if you have a Bible, you can go ahead and turn there, but I'm going to also read it. So you can read along with me if you would like. But it says, "And he began to teach them that the Son of Man must suffer many things and be rejected by the elders and the chief priests and the scribes and be killed, and after 3 days rise again. And he said this plainly. And Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. But turning and seeing his disciples, he rebuked Peter and said, 'Get behind me, Satan, for you are not setting your mind on the things of God, but on the things of man.' And calling the crowd to him with his disciples, he said to them, 'If anyone would come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whoever would save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake and the gospel's will save it. For what does it profit a man to gain the whole world and forfeit his soul? For what can a man give in return for his soul? For whoever is ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of him will the Son of Man also be ashamed when he comes in the glory of his Father with the holy angels." So there's a lot happening in this passage, but just to give y'all a little bit of context, this is happening right before Jesus is about to go to the cross, so right before he's about to die. And something that Drew points out is that in the passage, it says that Jesus is talking plainly. And this isn't usual for Jesus. This is actually very unusual, because in the Bible, a lot of times Jesus talks through parables, right? He talks through stories, and stories that make us think. But at this time, Jesus is talking straightforward and he's talking plainly. But even though he's doing this, the disciples are still having a hard time understanding what he's saying. And you can see that when Peter goes up and rebukes Jesus and asks him these questions in order to try and understand what he's saying and what's happening. But one particular verse that Drew points out is verse 35. So I'll go ahead and read that one more time. It says, "For whoever would save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake and the gospel's will save it." So just reading this out loud and kind of looking over it, at first it's kind of hard to understand and wrap your mind around, right? It's saying that whoever would save his life is going to lose it, but whoever loses his life will be saved. And so you can kind of understand where the disciples are coming from a little bit, of having trouble understanding what Jesus is saying. But one thing that Drew also points out is that the word save in this verse actually means rescue. And so Drew kind of calls this the paradox of life. So what it's saying is that whoever would rescue his life is going to lose it. But it's only God who can rescue us. So on our own and in our own power, if we try to rescue our life and rescue ourselves from our sinfulness and from that separation with God, we aren't able to do that. But it's only God who can come and rescue us. And so in Drew's sermon, he uses the example of someone who's swimming, right? And someone who's drowning. And when you're trying to go rescue someone, you can't rescue someone who doesn't want to be rescued, right? They have to willingly let you rescue them and willingly accept that help. And so a lot of times in the context of this verse, it's saying that when Jesus came and rescued us, when he came and died for us on the cross and rose again, he's offering us that rescue. He's offering us that hand. And all we have to do is surrender to that rescue, surrender to his strength in order to get this secured hope. A hope that's not only going to last this lifetime, but a hope that's going to last into eternity, right? So that we can be with him forever. And so Drew's main point from this sermon is, true life is found when we are willing to lay our lives down. So we have to be willing to surrender to God's rescue, surrender to his strength, and trust that he's going to rescue us and take care of us and acknowledge that we can't do it in our own power and in our own strength. And it's when we do that, it's when we believe that Jesus came and died for us on the cross and rose again and accept that gift, accept that rescue, that we're able to get this secured and unshakable hope that's never going to change and that's never going to fade. And so we need to stop swimming in our own strength and surrender to his strength and his power and his rescue in order to get the hope of heaven and in order to get this hope that we need in this lifetime. And honestly, a lot of times that can be hard, right? Because the world is often telling us that we need to do it on our own. We need to do it in our own strength in order to succeed, in order to save ourselves. And a lot of times that comes through material items, right? An example of that right now, people are fighting basically tooth and nail at Walmart for a roll of toilet paper. It's like Black Friday every day almost. But in the end, that's not going to give us that hope and that security that we long for. It's only in God and through Jesus that we're going to be able to receive that hope if we willingly let him help us. And so making that decision is going to help us get that hope. And so like always, we have a couple questions for y'all to go over with your life groups. If you have been able to meet with your life groups, that's awesome, guys. Keep it up. That's so cool that we're able to still connect and have community. But if you haven't been able to, make sure to reach out to your leaders and to your groups so that y'all can go over these questions and still have community with each other and just catch up and see how everyone is doing. But this week we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have 6 questions for y'all actually. So y'all are gonna have a lot to talk about this week. But the first question is, what does taking up your own cross look like now? The second one is, why do we resist rescue? In what parts of your life are you trying to swim in your own strength? What can we experience now when we allow Jesus to rescue us? What does it mean when Drew says we can be more? And lastly, are you really living in the hope of heaven? And what does that look like? So make sure that y'all reach out to your small group so that y'all can discuss these questions and discuss what Drew talked about in order to have that community. But we love you guys. We miss you. We hope you're doing well. Make sure to join us on Wednesday nights and to also do those stay-at-home challenges. This week is a really fun one. So if you don't know what that is, make sure to go check that out and submit it before the deadline. But I hope you have a great day, guys.